Good morning, students. I am Renu Arya, your maths teacher. Again, with you with our next topic, that is multiplication. In this chapter, we need to understand the basic terminology of multiplication. Let's start with the basic terminology: factor and product. We need to understand what factor is and what product is. Let's take an example. If we multiply two numbers, let us take 5 and 5. If we multiply 5 with 5, then the result will get this 25. Now, these numbers 5 and 5 are called factors, and after the multiplication of these numbers, the result we will get is called product. I repeat again, factor, when two numbers are multiplied with each other, then these two numbers are called factors. And after the multiplication, the result which we will get is called product. After that, we discuss about some properties of multiplication. Here are some properties of multiplication. Our first property is, when any number is multiplied by 0. When any number is multiplied by 0, then we'll get the result as 0. The result will be 0 in that case. Let us take an example to have that understanding. Let us take any number, let's say 15 is multiplied by 0. If we multiply 15 by 0, then we will get 0 as result. Our next property is, when any number is multiply by 1. If any number is multiplied by 1, let us take an example. 152 is multiplied by 1, then we will get 152 as result. Means the result will be the same number. If we multiply any number with 1, then we get the result with the same number. Our third property is order property. Of numbers. Order property. Order means arranging the number. Let us take an example. Suppose we have three numbers, 50, 60, and 1. 15, 6, and 1. Let us take an example. If we have three numbers and we have to multiply these numbers, if we change the order of these numbers, means अगर हम इनकी जो arranging है, उनको order कर देंगे, उनके order को अगर हम change कर देंगे, then there will be no change in the result. For example, if 15 is multiplied by 6 is multiplied by 1. We can either write this number as like this, or we can write it as 15 6 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 15. Here we change the order of the number. But if we change the order of the number, there will be no change in the result. The result will be same in both cases. Our next property is grouping property. Grouping property of numbers means, let us take an example. If we are given the three numbers 10, 6 and 7 and we have to make the group and after that we need to multiply, there will be no change in the result again. For example, if 10 is multiplied by 6 and we put these numbers within the bracket, after that these numbers are multiplied by 7 or 7 is multiplied by 6, we put these numbers within the bracket and after that multiplied by 10. In both cases, as you all know, first of all we need to open the bracket, means within the bracket we need to solve these numbers, 10 multiplied by 6, 16, then multiplied by 7. The result will be 420. In both cases, 42, open the bracket, multiply 10, the result will be same. Means in grouping property of numbers, if the grouping of the numbers will be rearranged, there will be no change in the result. Next is distributive property of numbers. Our next property is distributive property. Property over addition. Again, this is very important property to understand. If we are given with three numbers, let us take an example. 42 and open the bracket, after that multiply this by 15, the result will be 630. Now there are two ways to solve this question. Either we can solve it with the help of the grouping properties of the number, means the numbers within the bracket will be solved first, after that open the bracket and then multiply by the rest of the number. Either we can do this question as like previous method, or we can do it with the distributive property over addition, which means we need to open the brackets and multiply single digits with the number within the bracket. Let's understand with the help of example. Open the brackets. First of all, we need to multiply 15 by 40, then sign of addition, then multiply 15 by 2. In both cases, the result will be same. This is our distributive property over addition. Now in this chapter, our next topic is expanded notation. Multiply using expanded notation. Now what does it mean? As we already discussed in our previous classes, what expanded form means, expand means karvana, form means manavana, which means we see multiply the rest of the number with the numbers which we already written in the expanded form. Let's take an example to have better understanding. Let us take an example. 41 is multiplied by 5. Now you are asking that expand the number and then multiply with 5. We need to expand 41. Write it in expanded form first of all. 40 plus 1 and then multiply it with 5. Look here carefully. This is our distributive property over addition. Simply open the bracket one by one. Why open the bracket one by one? We will multiply the numbers 40 multiply 5 and sign of addition. Then 1 multiply 5. Now solve it further. 40 multiplied by 5, 200. 1 multiplied by 5, 5. 200 plus 5 is equal to 205. This is our multiply using expanded notation. So students, this is all about your chapter. I hope you enjoy this module. Thank you.